Christmas. It's Christmas Day. Way. Get in, my son. Hey. Christmas Day. It's Christmas Day. Have you got your presents? Did you get everything you asked for? I hope so. I did. I think so. Well, I don't know my presents yet, so I don't know. Because it isn't actually Christmas Day when I recorded this. I'm recording this on the Tuesday. In 1 week. 1 week today, it'll be Christmas Day. When you watch this, it'll be Christmas Day. Here's my tree, ready to go. Where's my presents? I don't know. I've got the TV going, ready to plan my Christmas. And I'm going to help you plan yours. I've just done a video helping you plan your Christmas TV. I've got my lights twinkling. I've got my tinsel up. It's Christmas. So, this is your Christmas Day special. Now, I took a lot of time to sort this out, so I hope you enjoy. Please, give me a Christmas present this year, everybody. Hit the thumbs up, everyone who watches this video. Everyone, hit the thumbs up. That'd be a great present. And drop me a comment below. Because if I get that, then the video will look great. It'll be like 300 views, 300 likes. Way, that'd be great. But I think you will enjoy this regardless of whether or not you want to hit that thumbs up or not. So, I have a friend. Yes, believe it or not, I do actually have a friend who works at Royal Mail. And he got in touch with me a while back and said, Ollie, you'll never guess what. This was beginning of December. I said, what's that, mate? I don't want to use his name. I don't want to get him into any trouble. He said, I have found a sack of letters. I thought, oh, okay. But you work at the post office, I expect you'll find lots of sacks of letters. He said, no, you won't believe what it is. I said, what is it? He said, it is Santa Claus letters. Like, dear Santa letters. I said, right, okay, like from kids and stuff. He said, no. He's marked big, a big P on the front and the back. I was like, right, okay, what about it? He says, it is Santa Claus letters from all of the Premier League managers. I'm like, are you joking? He said, no. Apparently every year the Premier League managers have to write a letter to Santa with what their Christmas wish is. And then the FA will deliver it to Santa personally with a carrot for Rudolph and the other reindeers and a mince pie and milk for Santa. And on top of that, he gets a free invite to any game he wants to go to. And all he's got to do is deliver these wishes. I'm like, you're joking. He said, no, it's true. I'm like, wow, how great is that? He says, do you want a copy of all the letters? I said, of course I do. Send them over to me right now. So I'm going to reveal to you what each Premier League manager has a wish for this Christmas in their very own letter to Santa. Believe it, baby. It's true. It's damn true. Okay. Here goes nothing. I hope you enjoy. Happy Christmas, by the way. Unai Emery's letter went like this. They're only short notes, by the way. Dear Santa. That's how he started. All I want for Christmas is a little bit of common sense being delivered to my club. Okay. I need to understand why we are paying Mesut Ozil £350,000 a week. Yet, we are still letting Aaron Ramsey, who is a nice boy, leave for free. Just like we did with that other very nice boy who isn't doing anything at his current club, Manchester United, Alexis Sanchez. Also, if it could be arranged for Real Madrid to sign Harry Kane, Dele Alli and Christian Eriksen from those lot down the road, that would really help me out a lot. The old man Wenger left the club in a bit of a mess. And the only way I can hope to get any respect from these dreadful fans is if we are the best team in North London. Right now, we are no That's me. He puts in big letters. They must have been talking like that. Who gave them a chance in the Premier League? Oh, and if you could make sure this joke is in the FA chairman's cracker, please. So when the FA chairman pulls his cracker on Christmas Day with his secretary under the desk, well, she'll be pulling his cracker under the desk. How do you pick the next England manager? You call Eddie Howe, that's how. Hey, that's quite entertaining, Eddie. Well done. Eddie Howe, desperate for the England job, obviously. Chris Hughton of Brighton and Hove Albion. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a Doctor Who time machine. I don't know if you can fit that in your sack, Chris. So I can send Glenn Murray back a few years, as he's our only chance of scoring, and every day he's getting older. That generally happens. If you can't fit a time machine into my stocking, then I'd be happy with you just ensuring Glenn eats his Christmas greens so he keeps up his fitness. That seems more than reasonable. I don't think he's going to get you a time machine though, Chris. I really don't see that. It might actually be easier to go and buy a new striker. There's a few around. I don't know if you've heard of scouts. Use them. Go and find one. Sean Dyche of Burnley. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is an explanation. How the hell have we gone from being so good last season and finishing so high in the table to being so poor this season? Please leave the answer in a stamped addressed envelope in my stocking so I can ask for further analysis if I'm not happy with your answer. Bloody hell, Sean. You don't have to get arsy with Santa Claus. He's only doing a job, which you should be doing right now. And you aren't doing your job. Burnley are poor. They're on the way down. Gutted, because I actually like Burnley. Neil Warnock of Cardiff City. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a hidden gem from the lower divisions that can come in and score me 20 goals in the Premier League. If you could squeeze Neil Maupay into a small box, then that would be good. He's doing fairly well in the Championship at Brentford. Failing that, just a nice big contract at a Championship challenging team for when I get the sack from Cardiff. Maurizio Sarri from Chelsea. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is some new nicotine patches, please. You know, the type that you put in your arm to stop you smoking. I've tried to stop smoking during the matches, but it's not working. I've started having a sly fag behind Loftus Cheek when he's on the bench, as he's quite tall and no one can see me there. Failing that, I'd be quite happy with 20 Benson and Hedges, please. Oh, and also, an idiot. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Oh, I can't read his writing. Oh, and also an idiot's guide on how to defend for David Luiz, please. A little book, an idiot's guide on how to defend. So, Sarri wants some nicotine patches or 20 Benson and Hedges. Roy Hodgson at Crystal Palace. Roy Hodgson. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is my two front teeth, as I'm getting older and don't want falsies just yet. Oh, and some sturdy springs that I can insert into Wilfred Zaha's boots so he stays on his feet a bit more. Also, if you could send the ghosts of Christmas past to Benteke one of the nights to remind him of years gone by when he was able to put the ball in the net rather than Rosette. You can't argue with that. Especially with the false teeth. And Zaha, if he had some springs in his boots, he wouldn't go down half as much as he does. Marco Silva of Everton. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a nice shiny cup. A little help to finish in the top six. Maybe send a little bad luck the way of Liverpool. And keep old Richie Richarlison fit and firing. If I could have all that, agreed to leave in January. I will eventually get rid of Tom Davies. And eventually, Dominic Calvert-Lewin will be gone. I'm going to rid the club of all semblance of Everton youth. I'm bringing all the Brazilians I can. So, Marco Silva is letting he's revealing his plans to decimate the Everton Academy. Claudio Ranieri of Fulham. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is 1 or 200 of Shad Khan's millions. 1 or 200 of Shad Khan's millions from his multi-billion bank account. Also, if he's prepared to set up a wrestling empire in America, then he could send us a few grapplers. If all that doesn't happen, maybe you could give me my old mucker, Jamie Vardy, a hint that moving to London would suit him and his missus. I can see Jamie Vardy at Fulham. Why not? He's not really fancied at Leicester at the minute under Claude Puel. I could see him moving to Fulham and picking up with Ranieri where he left off. Huddersfield Town and David Wagner. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is any kind of striker. They don't have to score 20 goals, 15 goals, not even 10 goals. If I could just have one or even two strikers who could score 5 goals each, that would be a huge help. Oh, and a pack of lovely Blutwurst or blood sausage, which are made with congealed pig or cow blood and contains fillers like meat, fat, bread or oatmeal. Yum yum. I would not want to eat that on my Christmas dinner. A blood sausage. It's filled with congealed pig or cow blood. I feel sick just thinking about that. Leicester City and Claude Puel. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a little Christmas joy. The club has gone through a really bad time recently, so if we could pick up a few points over the Christmas period and start afresh in the new year, that would be great. And a few bottles of 2007 Chateau Neuf de Pape. It's about £400 for 6 bottles online. If you could see your way to delivering a few crates in my stocking, I'd really appreciate it. The stuff I get down Tesco just doesn't cut it for me, I'm afraid. Failing that, I'd have to go to Aldi, and that's even worse. So, Chateau Neuf de Pape, £400, 6 bottles, a few crates. Thank you very much. Jurgen Klopp at Liverpool. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is an answer, really. See, I've been racking my brain for such a long time now. Not sure if it's due to the headbanging from my earlier years in Germany at the Johnny Doe Rock Club. But I can't seem to put my finger on the answer. I need to know why every time I manage to get my football club to the cup final, I always seem to mess it up. But that is true. I've lost my last 6 finals. I figured if you can teach reindeers to fly, then surely you know how I can win a final. I have no chance of catching Pepe Le Pew at City, so a cup is the next best thing. Please help Santa. So Klopp has realised he can't win a cup final and wants help from Santa to win one. Pep Guardiola at Man City. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is Leo Messi, Sergio Busquets, a clone of a younger Xavi and Iniesta, somebody to kidnap those pesky managers that won't stop chasing me in the league, Klopp and Pochettino. Every season I seem to have a new enemy at Chelsea. Arsenal now seem to have a spring in their step, and to top it all, I keep receiving text from my arch nemesis Jose saying he's going to keep signing players we want and destroy their confidence and talent. He's already done it with Fred and Sanchez. If he was to get his hands on Messi, Jose has the talent to turn him into Emil Heskey or worse, Gabby Agbonlahor. So Pep has finally figured out what Jose's plan is to destroy football as we know it. Jose of Man United, my club. Hello, guys. So what is Jose asking for? Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is Pep's little black book of tactics. His ability to connect with players. Maybe a job swap. And his brain while we are at it. If you can't deliver any of those for me, then I will settle for Fellaini to discover some long-lost brothers. About 9 of them should do it. Then I can sell Sanchez, Pogba, Lukaku, Lindorf, Eric Bailly and the rest of the useless kids and fill the team with 10 Fellainis and De Gea. Fellaini must be the long-lost son of, or the long-lost love child of Jose. He loves the man, and now he wants 10 more of them, or 9 more. Imagine that. 10 Fellainis in your team. Oh my god. I'd just give up watching football there and then. Rafa Benitez at Newcastle United. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a good fitted toupee. I'm sick of going bald. And especially up here in Newcastle, it's so bloody cold. Oh, if I could be cheeky and ask for a second present, I really want a new owner at the club. It's not that Mr. Ashley hasn't been good to me since I arrived. He takes me for a few beers Monday to Friday after training. I'm normally finished after one pint, but I smile and laugh at his jokes as he finishes off another 10 pints. But every pint he has, I see as for about 50 I could be using to strengthen the squad. At the rate we are going, the best I can hope for would be to bring back Andy Carroll from West Ham and try to get 2 games a season out of him. You really could see Newcastle bringing back Andy Carroll, couldn't you? Although, what's his name's doing quite well at the minute. Rondon, he's got a couple of goals lately. Now, these letters were wrote before, earlier on this month, so that was whilst Mark Hughes was still in a job. So we have Mark Hughes' letter here. Mark Hughes of Southampton at the time. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a better reputation. You see, I have a rep for making football clubs worse than they were when I joined. Stoke ended up relegated after I spent a few seasons there, as did QPR. I spent a shitload at Man City and ended up doing very bad. And now I'm doing the same thing at Southampton. So if you could just somehow convince people that I'm actually really good at my job, I'd really appreciate it, Santa. Thank you. Pochettino at Tottenham. Santa, all I want for Christmas is, well, it's not really a gift for me, it's for my frustrating chairman Daniel Levy. I really need you to send him a dose of common sense. Everyone knows I'm the best manager in the league. I'm working on a similar budget to clubs like Bournemouth and Leicester. West Ham and Fulham are now spending more than us, yet I'm expected to keep the team in the top 4. Pep goes to sleep wishing he was just half as good as me. Yet I go to sleep wishing I had his checkbook. While we are at it, could you please make sure our keeper, Hugo Lloris, keeps off the mulled wine this Christmas? We could really do without a repeat performance of his drink and driving. Oh, Poch getting a bit personal there. Javi Grazia at Watford. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is the chance to prove myself at Watford. Most of the fans didn't even know who I was when I arrived. Now I've had a great start to the season, and I really think I can do a Ranieri and win the league. Bit hopeful. Yet, any day could be my last. The club changes managers like I change my underwear. Maybe if you could leave a blank check in the bottom of my stocking as well, that would really help me push the club on. I'm thinking 500 million should at least get us on a level with Everton. Manuel Pellegrini of West Ham. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is for the fans to stop blowing those bloody bubbles all the time. At my age, to still have hair like I do is pretty impressive. So when all those bloody stupid bubbles pop, the residue ends up in my beautiful locks. I go home smelling like I've been in the pool. My missus doesn't like or watch football, so every Saturday night she starts accusing me of having an affair and that we're meeting up at the swimming baths. I tried to tell her about the bubbles, but she refuses to believe that grown men would spend time blowing bloody bubbles. Manuel Pellegrini, not impressed by West Ham fans blowing bubbles, obviously. Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a new striker, please. We are creating so many chances, yet my strikers couldn't hit a barn door with a banjo. They've done alright recently, though, to be fair. Obviously, he didn't know that was going to happen when he wrote this letter. The club's super agent, Jorge Mendes, has done so well bringing in the players he has, but I know, and the club know, that as soon as a bigger club comes sniffing around for Jota and Neves, then they'll be off like a shot. Maybe you could just bring players in for us and not try to move them on, possibly. One last thing, Santa. Could you please leave a season ticket to our home games in the stocking of the best ASMR content creator in the world? Hashtag Ollie's ASMR World. Thanks, Santa. Little